Ramona Radio. Live from the United Kingdom. It's Vince Staples, Westside Tie, the best DJ in the world. Yo. This episode is about the beats.
Ramona Radio.
They not prepared, Ty.
I don't think so.
Shout out the whole UK. Shout out everybody who's ever made a beat in their life.
Yeah, rest in peace, Prince Philip.
Rest in peace, Phil. Rest in peace, Queen. Rest in peace, D.
I had a good run, man.
We love you.
Slow B. Yeah.
Bass God.
My new name is Bass God. Ice cream.
We get into a lot of beautiful music today.
It's a different game. Baby girl, we in Hollywood, St. Mary Lane.
Make sure you turn this up. It's nothing more important than a low end. We gonna get into that later. Shout out Franklin. We play all the beautiful music out on the radio. We live from London today. Beautiful place, it's inspired a lot of my work. Not our work. How you feeling, Westside Ty?
Come on, man. I'm here to remind niggas that there was a two-step garage intro on the Def Jam US release, bro.
Look, man, they'll get it when they're older.
It's true. It's
shout true. Out Zach Seekoff, one of the best. How old was he when he made this beat?
Shit. Probably 19 on the couch. Yeah, he was at the crib, man.
Child prodigy. This episode is about production because production is one of the most important parts of music, you know? It's my favorite part of music. It's the part I connect to the most.
Crabs in a bucket.
Let's get into it. Ramona Radio, Vince Staples, Westside Tie, the best DJ in the world. Ramona Radio, like we said before, live from London. My name is Vince Staples. This is Westside Tie, the Beeper King, the best DJ in the world.
Beeper King.
Yeah.
We got Corey Smith here, too, in the cut somewhere. Man, talk to the people, man. Talk to the people.
Oh, he's on the road, man.
What are we doing? Where Corey Mike at? Is he right here?
Play some more instrumentals, man.
You want me to talk to the people, bro?
I needed you to talk.
Come on, man. What are we doing?
We just in here, man. We talking over this one, bro.
Like we said about, man, this is about production, right? Everybody got a favorite beat. Everybody has a favorite song, favorite producer. But it's time to highlight that. You get what I'm saying? I can remember back in the day sitting at that lunch table. Picked up the pencil, ashy hand, grinding beat. And from there, it only grew. Back in Corey day, it was beatboxing. It was breakdancing, all the elements. What's your favorite beat, Westside Ty? Just give me two. It don't gotta be the favorite. Just give me two that just stand out.
I mean, I already played one. I'm God by Clams Casino is all-timer, bro. That changed our lives. Yeah, man.
I never heard it like that until that.
What you mean?
Clams it was innovative.
Yeah.
It was so heavy, but it was still light. It was like a saltine cracker. Like, it's salty, but it's crispy, and it's like, I like salty.
Did you
crackers.
Just call Imogen Heap a cracker, bro?
Yeah. I didn't mean to, though. I just really like saltine crackers.
Oh, God. Oh, God. You, yeah, at the park?
At the park.
Box. Yeah, that shit go crazy.
It's
right.
It's going to fill you up, but you light on your feet. And right. Then, you know, now you finna hit a double. What about you, Corey?
I mean, it's a lot to choose from, bro. It's got to be some Della or some Diamond D. Got something in there.
For the kids who don't know, please look up Diamond D and please look up J Dilla. I know you probably heard the name J Dilla before, but you haven't really looked into it. We talking about real innovation.
Yeah.
Me, I don't know, man. I would probably have to say, Soof, man.
It's tough.
You're nobody till somebody kills you. That's up there.
Yep.
Sub crazy. That's up there.
Yep.
Lauryn Hill doo-wop. I'm into the classics, bro. I like
I feel
hits.
You.
I'm not
I feel
like
you.
Hits. I'm not going.
I feel
lie.
You. I feel you. Look, on some UK shit. Me and Nakam was riding around to Dizzy Rascal, Boy in the Corner, bro. First time I heard "I Love You," my We almost crashed the car, bro.
That might be the first. That might be the first British rapper. Well, no, knowingly.
Right.
British
rapper.
Yeah,
not Slick Rick.
Yeah, not Slick
Rick.
Not Doom. Shout out to yeah, because don't forget.
Right. Shout outs to the guys.
Shout outs to the guys.
Immigration and politics. You know
what I mean? Yeah, man. Yeah. Did Slick Rick get deported?
Nah, he ended up just going to jail. And then they didn't deport him back.
I would have went home. I would have went home.
He came
man.
Back, man.
Yeah, I mean, things happen.
He back in New York, man.
He's living life. We saw him at the thing with Julian.
Nice suit, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, every time I see him, it's 30 chains.
Him and Mandy, yo, they be living life.
Yeah, hey, as
bro,
you should.
We were at like a banquet for a charity, and he was just sitting there with the headphones on, just listening to hip hop. He didn't know what was going on.
He not even talking to niggas.
Nah, he was at the charity banquet listening to hip hop, bro.
He was focused. He was trying to get some more rhymes out. He was, you know.
I love that.
And every time you see Slick Rick, it's like, that's Slick Rick. So it's like, what's up, Mr. Slick Rick? Like, we just always so cool, bro.
Right.
And he got that, bro. Some of them beats, oh my God. That album, a lot of people, you know, you go Lottie Daddy, you go Children's Story, but that post-incarceration release.
Yeah, that was a joint.
Oh my God.
I mean, the art
God.
Of storytelling. Come on, gang.
Yeah, got,
I mean, you could just start with the show, though. Come on.
Also like, that. Yeah. I mean, he's got the Slick is.
Hold on. It must be said early on. Y'all don't respect Jazzy Jeff enough.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God. What? He's still one of the best DJs in the world. Like,
I'm starting to feel away.
As of now.
I'm going to let it go. But in about 6 months, I'm going to get mad. I'm just warning everybody.
Yeah.
Y'all got 6 months.
It's gonna be turn up time, bro.
If I don't see something in 6 months, it's
danger. That's crazy.
The other day I was Swiffer in the house listening to the first album. And I got mad, bro. I called Tim Henshaw and I yelled at him until he hung up on me.
About Jazzy Jeff? What Tim Henshaw got to do with Jazzy Jeff?
I just never seen him say nothing about him.
True indeed. Yeah.
So I just had to call him. I'm like, y'all into all this hip hopping right now. It's beef time. I get it. But everybody hip hopping. Nobody bringing up Jazzy Jeff. He hung up on me. Then I called Barry. I'm like, hey man, I know y'all out there dream villain, but I ain't heard nobody say nothing about Jazzy Jeff.
Not one word about Jeff.
And y'all want to talk hip hop. So round of applause for Jazzy Jeff. You one of my favorites.
I get my actual joint, man.
You one of my favorites.
Let's get into this Alchemist voice note, bro.
Oh yeah. So hold on.
We got niggas calling in about the beats, man.
What I wanted to do, you know, and we're not going to talk that much. So I'm trying to get it out the way because I just really want y'all to listen to this music. I'm not going to scream over the records like I usually do. You know, I'm a little flex. But
we could do that too. That should be fun to listen to. Yeah, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, we can do that too. Yeah, I need some reverb, Apple. Y'all need to put that in the App Store. Like just something to give me some, you know, some boisterousness.
Nah, they got that. The iOS. I'll hit you with the plugins.
Hit me with the plugins.
Yeah.
But it's so many great producers. We know so many great people that we just wanted to kind of get some of their insight on how they produce, how they create, to kind of let you guys know what goes on behind the curtains of making these amazing beats that we love to listen to. So first up, we have The Alchemist.
No matter what we fear, we must fear the moment of truth, baby.
The beats that got me inspired are probably the first stuff that I heard. The ones that really affected me was like DJ Premier, primarily. But then there was Pete Rock, it was Large Professor, it was Diamond D, it was Muggs. It was just a whole conglomerate of producers who all had their individual style and sound that they were using based on the type of samples, of course, Q-Tip as well. Just based on the samples that they used and their technique of how they manipulated it, like everybody had a unique style. And that inspired me because I rap first, but beats were, you know, that's your best friend if you rap. So I always had like opinions on the beats I wanted to rap to. So when I got a chance to make beats, I was so inspired. Also on the West Coast, you had J Swift, you had E Swift, you had Battle Cat, DJ Quick. My God, Broadway. There were so many producers who I definitely got inspiration from. When you make an album for somebody, I feel like that's a different skill than just making beats. because it's kind of like you're the skipper of a ship, or you're really the guy running the ship. You know what I mean? You're the main guy. You're the captain. I don't know why that escaped me. You're the captain of the ship when you produce an album. So it's kind of like also a referee of a game when you want to just keep the ball in play. You want to make sure it doesn't go out of bounds and it stays within a certain parameter. Like, I like to pick bookends and put them on the beginning and end when I'm making an album and stick in a certain area. So you can kind of create. But it's really your job is to give the person a backdrop so they can write and create, first and foremost, the record they want to make from their writing. And then you have to finish it, put the pieces together, and essentially make what is kind of like a film, just but in an audio version. And the things that inspire me today are very random. Like, I get inspired by architecture. I get inspired by smells and scents. I get inspired by, like, nature. Things that you wouldn't expect. Because as artists, we kind of draw inspiration from a lot of different places. So, yeah, but if I'm not inspired, I won't even do anything. I never push myself. I always wait until I'm having fun and enjoying the moment. And that's my cheat code.
Shout out Earl Sweatshirt. God MC.
What this popcorn about? Microwave oven while you out
there.
Shout out
Microwave. Ramona Radio, we gonna keep it going. The most eclectic show in the universe. Shout out Love. Do not let the drums evade you. Keep the rhythm. Put your heart into it. Stay on beat. Here we go. Shout out to DPG. Shout out Dairy Dog. Shout out Joe Cool. RIP VIP Records.
Nigga West comes up in the house. Leave you trapping in the south. Bring the groove to your face.
Make sure y'all stream Dark Times. Stream Dark Times right now. Shout out Def Jam. Shout out Freedom. Ramona Radio, that song is called Lil Homies. That's off the new Vince Staples album, Dark Times. Go stream that right now.
Clap it up, man. It's a
go
good album.
Buy that right now. Thank you, my friend.
Yeah, go get you a... Oh, no, the vinyl's just... I didn't even get a vinyl. Goddamn.
I
bet you sold out quick, gang.
Yeah, I was like, I ain't gonna lie.
Type shit.
But I gotta get my shit to Flea, man. He made me feel bad.
What happened?
He just... Like, every day I just see a positive interaction from Flea.
Hanging out with Ken Carson?
Yeah, and he DM'd me like, hey, you know, make more vinyls, my friend. And I'm like, damn. Here, Nick. Like,
yeah. You got it. Come on. That's a California legend, bro.
California legend, man. Shout out Flea. Shout out Dark Time. Shout out Leor. Everybody involved. Yeah, man. I think it's really important to do these kinds of episodes because that beat is important. Regional music is important. When I hear that, I hear the song that played before it. I hear Kelly is active. I hear Which One of You Be Words Like Me by Snoop Doggy Dogg. I hear
song.
Deep Cut Snoop.
Fresh Pair of Panties. He got some joints.
Shout
bro,
out
where
Snoop.
He's not. Yeah. Them ones.
I hear DJ Quick. I hear Mossberg. I hear Kendrick. You know, regional music is so important. That song was recorded in Los Angeles, California, produced by a producer from Inglewood, California, telling a Long Beach, California story. And it's all the same. It's all beautiful. And I think it's important to let you guys know why we make this music, what inspires us with this music, and what inspires the producers. So with no further ado, hear from the man himself, leken Taylor, the producer of Lil Homies off of Dark Times by Vince Staples.
It's leken Taylor.
We're here live at Ramona Radio with the homies. Thank you for having me. I appreciate it. If I had to say what beats that really got me into producing, I'd say songs like Allure by Jay-Z. I'd say Butter by A Tribe Called Quest. A lot of NERD and My High, Fly or Die. Lupe Fiasco. Can't forget about Lupe. I remember it was 07. I think the iPod Touches just dropped. Got one for Christmas. Got an iTunes gift card also for Christmas. First album I bought, I want to say, was The Cool. So I can't forget about Lupe, but like songs like I Got You, songs like Go Watch. What else? Lucy Pearl, You, Crazy, Raphael Sadiq went nuts on that. What else? Can't forget about Battle Cat. I'm from the city. Can't forget about Battle Cat. And We Can Freak It, Corrupt. What else? Cali Is Active. You got Little Brother, I'm Loving It. You got Alchemist, Hold You Down. You got 3-6 Mafia, They Fly. You got Kanye, Paranoid. Man, you even got Sky Might Fall, Kid Cudi. Like, a lot of that stuff right there is stuff I really listen to a lot, like my childhood. I say 07, 08, 09, and that was when I was really growing and really understanding music. And the chord structure of a lot of that stuff is what was really intriguing to me, the sonic bed of it. And I say that's what got me into producing. For the album Dark Times, I came in as a producer, and my role ended up growing to co-executive producer. That involved me overseeing a lot of the music production process, selecting songs for track listing purposes, hiring like my sister to do additional vocals at the end of Lil Homies, working very close with Tyler Page, our engineer, to make sure that these songs got to where they needed to be, and, you know, bringing the project to fruition. What inspires me today? Family and friends. I know that's a pretty cliche answer, but that, building a legacy, and having a good time in the studio, I feel like those for sure the things that keep me inspired and keep me grounded. Having a good time. Sam.
Ramona Radio.
Tyler Page, how you doing? Stream Dark Times now. Ramona Radio, Westside Ty, Vince Staples. Rest in peace, Rico Wade. This might actually be my favorite beat. I apologize for what I said earlier. Ramona Radio.
Boy, yeah, right.
Vince Staples, Westside Ty, the Beeper King.
Boy, yeah, right,
Corey Blacksmith
yeah, right,
here
yeah,
with
right.
us. Rest in peace, SOPHIE. Shout out Kushka, shout out the whole Australia. Shout out Floon. Shout out Cookie Time. Vince Staples, Westside Ty, the Beeper King. We got Corey Blacksmith in the building. We want to just say rest in peace to SOPHIE.
Oh, God. That was the closest thing you get into another J Dilla in this lifetime. She was that. She was one of them, gang.
I just never seen, I've never seen that much psychotic behavior on that keyboard. I'm telling you, bro, just to see, like, the organization.
Yeah.
But also, like, the sporadic nature.
Yeah, the mono machine neatly placed next to the keyboard with Logic and then just sending shit in and out,
bro.
Still kind of don't get it, but
we were in London, or I think it was LA, and Jimmy and all them had a house, and we went to the house. The house looked like, you know how you got the scene in the movie where it's like the short dude with the glasses in the library, and he know where all the books is at.
Yeah,
it was that with the keyboard, with the just the sense. Like, I'm talking about one over here. 5 minutes, we done. What you want to eat? So shout out to SOPHIE for being one of the greatest ever. She was the one.
Every time.
We see a lot of y'all talking. We see a lot of y'all bringing up shows, contributions to production, you know, at a later date. And that is greatly appreciated. Keep the name alive. Keep the legacy alive.
Every time.
Every single time. If you just finding out, put somebody else on. Keep it alive. Share it. And we're going to keep playing it here at Ramona Radio. Rest in peace. Shout out Real Hip Hop. I need everybody to do the Charlie Brown right now. Ramona Radio, PSA. Y'all got about a week or 2 weeks before y'all stop sleeping on Tinashe. She giving us heat. Glendale's own.
You feel me?
Glendale's own. and she got a hit right now. And Ramona Radio, us, the guys, we support that real music. Produced by Zach Seacoff. I see you, boy.
Ever heard of him?
I see you.
Big Fish Theory, ever heard of it?
I see you.
Pico Boulevard, ever been there?
I see you. Love Tinashe, love Zach. Ramona Radio, the best radio show in the world. Vince Staples, Westside Todd, the Beaver King, the greatest DJ in the world.
Beaver King.
We'll see y'all next week.